Consider the equation x squared plus 6x plus 11 is equal to 0. Calculate the discriminant and determine the number of real solutions. Well, first of all, notice that our equation is a quadratic equation. The equation x squared plus 6x plus 11 equals 0, it has the form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a, the coefficient of x squared, is 1, b, the coefficient of x, is 6, and c, the constant term, is equal to 11. To calculate the discriminant, we need to recall that the discriminant is b squared minus 4ac. So to find the discriminant, we'll substitute 6 for b, 1 for a, and 11 for c. When we do, we get 6 squared minus 4 times 1 times 11. 36 minus 44 is negative 8, so the discriminant is negative 8. The next thing we're asked to do is to determine the number of real solutions to our equation. Well, to solve a quadratic equation, we use the quadratic formula. The quadratic formula says that the solutions to the quadratic equation are given by the formula x is equal to the opposite of b plus or minus the square root of the discriminant all divided by 2a. So all we need to do to find the solutions is to substitute in the appropriate values for a, b, and c. So we'll substitute 6 for b, we'll substitute negative 8 for the discriminant, and we'll substitute 1 for a. We find that x is equal to negative 6 plus or minus the square root of negative 8 all divided by the product of 2 and 1. Well, in order to evaluate this expression, we'd have to find the square root of negative 8. But the square root of negative 8 is not a real number. That indicates that this equation has no real solutions. So we see that the discriminant is negative 8 and that there are no real solutions. Therefore, A is the correct answer. The discriminant helps us to determine the number of real solutions. When the discriminant is negative, then we end up having to find the square root of a negative number when we're solving the equation, and the result is that there are no real solutions. If the discriminant had turned out to be 0, the square root of 0 is 0, and when you add or subtract 0 from a number, you just get that number. So if the discriminant is 0, then there would just be one real solution. If the discriminant had turned out to be positive, then the square root of a positive number is another positive number. And when you subtract or add a positive number to a number, you get two different numbers. We would end up with two different real solutions.